Hey, I was getting the oil changed and I saw this little doggy in the window and I figured Emma hasn't had a pregnant in what, 3-4 days? So I thought, what are you doing?
I'm never getting my body back. I'm gonna be fat and ugly for the rest of my life.
Hey, don't say that, you're beautiful.
No, I'm not.
Baby crying?
No.
What's wrong?
I guess it just got to me when I was watching Sunny holding Emma. It reminded me of Michael when he was a little boy. You know, like there's so many people around him that love him, and still, what happened to him is completely senseless. You know, and it just reminded me how fragile children really are.
Robin, nothing's gonna happen to Emma.
I know it's different because, you know, Sonny's a mobster and that's why Michael got shot, but things happen to kids all the time who aren't related to mobsters. I mean, I just honestly don't know what I would do if something happened to Emma.
What happened to Michael was tragic, but those circumstances are one in a billion.
Tragedies happen every day. Medical illnesses, you know, fluke accidents.
And there are also millions of children that live their lives happy and healthy with nothing more than an ear infection and scraped knee. Let's at least give Emma a chance to be one of those kids. Healthy, happy, and safe.
Listen, I know that you mean well, okay? And I want to believe you, but don't you think it's a little arrogant to think that we're above all of that? I mean, yeah, maybe I got lucky and I didn't get full-blown AIDS and I didn't die.
Robin, you've successfully lived with HIV. That's huge.
Well, it doesn't mean that I haven't had my share of illnesses and loss and now I'm magically immune. I mean, there's just so many things that could go wrong that I didn't even consider.
What's going on with you? Robin, this isn't like you at all.
What's that supposed to mean? You know, you don't bring a child into this world because of some misplaced sense of entitlement, you know? It takes a lot of thought, it takes a lot of planning, and I don't know, a little bit of humility.
We thought about it plenty. We talked it to death.
Never mind. Obviously, I'm not explaining it right.
No, you're explaining it fine. It's an emotional time for you.
It's an emotional time for me? I'm a doctor, okay? I know all about hormones.
Okay, well, it's one thing to know about them, and it's another thing to live through them. Maybe we should just go talk to Dr. Kelly about this.
No, we are not going to do anything.
Robin, is it possible you're suffering from postpartum depression?
Where did that come from?
You've just been all over the place emotionally.
Yeah, I had a baby, I almost died, and we got married within the span of a few months. I think I'm allowed to be a little bit off.
Listen, I'm not criticizing you. I'm concerned about
you. I can't believe you're serious. Just drop it, okay?
Consider it dropped.
This, there's gonna be germs all over it.
Well, guess you can't be too careful.
What's that?
It is for you.
It's for me?
Yes. I was out and about and I saw it and I thought, you know what? Let me get you something for our 1 month anniversary, but then I thought, why not?
Well, I can't imagine what I need. I mean, unless it's those sheets for the crib. Wow. That's really sexy.
You're still the sexiest woman I know.
Come on.
Would I lie about that?
I don't feel very sexy right now.
Well, why don't you go try it on? Maybe it'll change. Emma's still sleeping. It's perfect timing.
Yeah, you know, I'm just, I don't think that I'm ready. I'm sorry.
It's okay.
But thank you for that. It's really pretty.